It's a national holiday. Pitchers and catchers are starting to report. I'm seeing photos of it in my timeline. It's awesome. But along with that, we also got 2020 predictions from Bakota. Let's break them down and see what they got. Hey guys, it's Josh, and now you know it all, coming to today to talk about the fact that pitchers and catchers are starting to report multiple teams. I've got pictures, videos going on my Twitter timeline. I'm loving it. Along with that, we actually have the 2020 Pakoda breakdown for their predictions for this year. I'm going to go over those really quickly, kind of see what they think and, you know, kind of disagree with quite a few things. But guys, before we jump into that, don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Just down below, you click on the little subscribe button. That'll let you know when we have more videos coming out. You can come back and watch them. Also, don't forget to like the video. It does help out so that more people can come and catch our channel and be a part of the 90 Know-It-All Empire. But guys, let's jump right into this. I have the papers. I have last year's and this year's stuff. I wanted to look at last year's to see how right they were or how off they were. Now, there's a few things. Now, obviously, they're not going to predict teams to win 120 games, that type of stuff. They're going to try and keep it, you know, in a certain thing. But the algorithm, although it works sometimes, is can be really off other times. I mean, last year, they had Tampa Bay being 86-76. Tampa Bay went on to win 96 games, you know, make the wild card. And they had them predicted to be third behind the Red Sox. Another big one. They had Oakland predicted to be 79-83. They had them predicted to be a losing record. Oakland won 97 games last year. A little bit off. Same thing, Minnesota. They had them to win 81 games and go 500. Minnesota won 101 games. So I take this with a little bit of a grain of salt. I don't really like their predictions sometimes. Some of them are obvious. They had the Yankees winning a lot. That was obvious. Houston winning a lot. That was pretty obvious. They had the Dodgers winning 93 games, which they won 105, but really no one projects or predicts a team to win 105 games. So, yeah, so I have no problem with those predictions. They actually had Pittsburgh Pirates predicted to go 500 last year. 69-93 was what they ended up going. They actually had, Baltimore winning 59 games. They ended up winning 54, so that was actually pretty close. There's a number of them. There's a few things. You know, these are just predictions. They can't predict injuries, that type of stuff. But even some of the predictions this year, they blow my mind. They make me kind of wince a little bit when I look at them. Like the biggest one that I looked at is the Atlanta Braves. They had them going 83-79. This is a team that won 97 games last year, and they're predicting them to be 16 games worse than last year. The Braves are not going to be 16 games worse than last year. They're just not. They are a good team. They got a good core of hitters, young hitters, guys who are coming up. That team's going to compete for the division title, and they're going to be in the 90 win total. I think they're going to win at least 90, 92. I mean, maybe even hit 95, 96 and be close to last year's total. So I don't like, I don't know where these predictions, what all they do and take into account. Because for the NL East, they have the Mets winning the East with 88 wins. Come on. Come on. Maybe it's, and I know it's some computer algorithm, but the Mets, 88, they're going to beat the Nationals, who are not as strong as last year. They lost Rendon. That is a huge impact. They're not going to be as strong. But the Braves are still good. So why would they suddenly drop to third place? Now, the Marlins are last. Philadelphia Phillies, they have them at 77-85. I think they're going to be better. I think the Phillies are going to be better than that. So the fact that it has the Mets winning the East makes me scratch my head, and I don't believe that one bit. For the Central, it has the Reds winning the Central. That one's interesting. I can see that happening. I can see that being realistic. It has them winning 86 games, which last year they won 75. They've added a lot of good pieces this offseason. That's a realistic number for them, I think. That's a realistic shot for them. NL West, they have the Dodgers predicted to win 103 games. Yeah, I can see that. I can see that. The thing that's crazy, though, is they have the Padres predicted second with 79 wins. I guess I could see that, too. I don't. they're a young group and they got hot. They could do it. The Diamondbacks, though, they have them at 79 wins as well. They're better than a 79-win team. I think the Diamondbacks are strong. They have the Rockies 4, Giants 5th, and I think that's pretty realistic. Over in the American League, they have the Yankees, 100, they got them at 99 wins, which, yeah, I can see them winning 99 games, especially with Baltimore stinking, Toronto not doing great, Boston losing players. Makes sense. The Central, they got the Twins, Indians, the White Sox. Yeah, those teams all make sense. And then the West, they've got the Angels winning 87 games, being second place behind the Astros, and the A's at 85 games. The A's won 97 games last year, and I don't think they are 12 games worse. So looking at this, you know, I understand this is all computer algorithm, that type of stuff, computing war and all that stuff, but in the end, I just, you know, it's fun. It's fun to see this, see what they're saying. The fact that they have the Reds winning the Central in the National League, I kind of agree with that. But there's no way I'm having the Mets win the NL East. Not a chance. That's the Braves division to lose, and they're not going to lose it to the Mets. So, guys, that's just a quick breakdown. My thoughts. The most important thing to take away from this, spring training has started. Pitchers and catchers, they're in bullpens. They're throwing pitches. Yes, it's finally here. College baseball is here. I'm pumped. This is the time of year that needs to happen. So, guys, I'm excited for what's going on. I hope you are too. Remember, don't forget to subscribe. We're going to have lots of content, lots of things going on during the baseball season. Catch you guys later.